In this lecture, we discuss some basic definitions and theorems related to linear models. Using linear models, we can predict the future outcomes of a target variable based on the related variables. Linear models are widely used in statistical data analysis when the dependent or the response variable y is quantitative, whereas the independent variables or predictor variables x are quantitative, qualitative, or both. Depending on variable type of the response variable and predictor variables, we have different types of linear models. For example, when both response variable and predictor variables are quantitative, we have regression models. When response variable is quantitative and predictor variables are qualitative, we have analysis of variance or ANOVA models. When response variable is quantitative and some of the predictor variables are quantitative and some are qualitative, we have analysis of covariance or ANCOVA models. When defining linear models, we mainly consider the fluctuations of the response variable y. For example, assume that the response variable y fluctuates about an unknown parameter neta. Then we can write this fluctuation mathematically as y equals neta plus epsilon. Here epsilon is the fluctuation or error. Assume that we can expect neta in terms of x variables as given in this expression. Here x1, x2 up to xp minus 1 are non-constants and beta values represents unknown parameters to be estimated. Note that when x variables are varied and y1, y2 up to yn of y are observed, then each yi can be written according to this equation. By combining equations of all y variables, now we can write this matrix form. For all y variables, we have a n by 1 y vector to represent all x values in each equation. Now we have the x matrix, which is n by p. Since all equations, there is no x value corresponding to beta naught, the elements of the first column of matrix x should be equal to 1. If all x variables are quantitative, the matrix x having dimension n by p is called the regression matrix, and rank of matrix x is assumed to be equal to p. Then we say that the matrix x is of full column rank matrix. However, in some experimental design solutions, the elements of matrix X are chosen to be 0 or 1 when all or some of the X variables are qualitative. Then the columns of matrix X may be linearly dependent. Then we commonly call the matrix X as the design matrix. One such example is the one-way analysis of variance model as shown here. Look at the X matrix in this example, which includes 0 or 1. A one-way ANOVA only involves one factor or independent variable, which may include three or more categorical groups. Another example that the matrix X is having only zeros and ones is the two-way analysis of variance model. A usual form of such a model is given here. In a two-way ANOVA model, there are two factors or two independent variables which compares three or more categorical groups at each factor level. Analysis of covariance or ANCOVA model is another example that the matrix X represents a design matrix. Look at the X matrix in this example. In this model, some of the X variables are qualitative and some are quantitative. And in this lecture series, we concentrate to regression models. Now we have a question. Why we use the term linear in the regression models? The model is linear means that it is linear in the unknown parameters beta. Now we consider some special cases of the linear regression model. By setting xij equals to xi to the power j and k equals p minus 1, we can obtain this polynomial model. Note that this model also linear in the unknown parameters beta. Therefore, this model also can be taken as a linear regression model. Look at this model. It is also a special case of a linear model since it is linear in the unknown parameters beta. However, the model shown in equation 5 is a non-linear model since it is non-linear in the parameters beta.